to the Trojan family, near and far. A warm welcome inside Van Dixhorn Arena. This is Ethan Oskroba on the call tonight, welcoming you in for what should be a great evening of Trojan basketball. We started off with your TIU Trojans taking on the visiting Red Hawks of Indiana University Northwest. The Trojan women out there, they are 3-20 on the year, looking for their first win here at Van Dixhorn and trying to snap a five-game skid. It'll be no easy task against the Red Hawks as there's a great cut toward the inside. It is Tiara Jackson getting on the board on the brilliant feed there. But the Red Hawks are in the midst of a terrific campaign, as it will go the other way. IUNW, a total mark of 19-5, as well as 14-2 in the conference. They are 10-2 on the road this season, so they are certainly used to playing their best ball well away from their home court. Now here's a collision under the bucket, and Carly Miller, the Red Hawk guard, a little shaken up as Braylee Gula is called for the foul. She was clutching at her ankle here, so hopefully not as serious as it looks at the moment. She'll get some medical attention. But these Red Hawks certainly having a tremendous campaign. They sit atop the CCAC in a cluster. There are five teams with two or three losses, but IUNW tied for the conference lead with their Hoosier counterpart, Indiana University South Bend. The Trojans have struggled in conference play as they will look to right some of those wrongs. They were victorious in just their second conference game as Miller is able to get to her feet. That's great to see, though she's not putting any weight on that leg. Really unfortunate as the training staff will help her to the sideline, so hopefully get a good diagnosis on her. It looked like the right ankle. And probably just an awkward landing as she was clear for takeoff, but never quite made it to her apex as she careened into Gula. No ill intent for sure, as we will resume play. Correction, it looks like the call was an offensive foul against Miller, so it goes back the direction of the Trojans. Kaya Albert nearly at her pocket picked, now flails up a shot, and she'll head to the line after drawing the contact. Good aggression from one of the Trojan captains, Kaya Albert. But to finish that story, the Trojans victorious in just their second conference game of the season. They have since lost 14 successive contests in the CCAC. So they're looking to alter that tonight. And it won't be easy against the strong Red Hawk team, especially with a shorthanded lineup. The Trojans devoid of each of their top three scorers on the season as Albert hits the second, including their megastar point guard, Denaria Washington, the sophomore from Indianapolis, the triple-double machine that was Washington, still sidelined for the Trojans. Now here's a three-pointer. It is Caitlin Halfacre coming up short. Rebound corralled by Hattie Black. Black was only a couple minute a game player in the early going. She has been very steady this year, has consistently seen her role grow as the season goes on. Now Amber Reynolds spraying free, but it's rejected by Jackson. So Tiara Jackson has made her presence felt on both ends of the floor here in the opening minutes of this one. Albert will inbound. Quick pass down the baseline, but Albert stepped out. Some miscommunication from the blue and white. Michaela Best will run the point here. She slips free. Now Halfacre bombs away again, and she sticks that one. Second three-point attempt already for Halfacre, who came in to replace the injured Miller, and she makes an immediate impact with a triple there. Now the feed for Gula, overshot, two-on-one for the visitors, and a nice finish by Sarah Martin. Good hustle by Reynolds to make a play out of it. Timeout called. A quick timeout, just 2 minutes and 12 seconds into this one, and IUNW has ambushed the TIU Trojans on their home court. Coach PA wants to talk it over. Well, sometimes it's tough to get yourselves going in any sort of a contest, but especially with the early injury to Miller, really just throwing off the flow of this game. A quick update on her. She is returning to the Red Hawk bench and walking a little bit gingerly, but she is walking on that injured ankle, so hopefully she's shaken off the majority of the effects of that injury and has at least been cleared to return with her teammates, so that's a great sign. Inbound here for the Trojans. Reynolds works her way free, working against Sarah Martin. Reynolds driving the left hand, pirouettes, kicks out to Black. Black, as Albert slips free of the screen, hop step inside, but she traveled with it. Couldn't quite bring both the feet down in conjunction. Counts as two steps. She took a third and gets called for the violation. There is another long bomb from Caitlin Halfacre, and she flashes the three fingers after drilling that one and now makes a great defensive play. As Black stepped on the boundary, Hattie Black wanted a call there. As Halfacre flashed in, might have clipped Hattie on the chin there, is what she was signaling, but no call. And the active defense paying off. Quick start from the visitors. Here's Alina Santiago. Almost had a free lane to the bucket, and now indecision from Martin, who shuffled with the rock. We will see some action here for the Trojans for Jasmine Smith, promising young guard for them, checking in for the first time. A little push shot from Gula. Braylee Gula was looking for the bank, did not get it there. The Red Hawks come away with it. So an uncharacteristically small crowd here at Van Dixhorn. This game has almost a scrimmage type of vibe. It feels very laid back tonight and just tough to produce that intensity artificially. But that's what you got to do in practice every day, and Coach PA never ceases to preach attitude and effort, and we'll see if the Trojans can showcase some of those characteristics here as Gula's pass to the outside, intercepted by Santiago. She'll fling it over to Best. Now here is Halfacre, who's had the hot hand, and there's a great feed and one for Tiara Jackson, who is going to be tough to contain under the tin tonight, already flashing some great skill in the post as she was just a step quicker than Braylee Gula on that occasion. Jackson comes up short. Best came soaring in for the board, but Albert is able to keep a cool head and corral it. Now she throws it away. Halfacre feeling herself here off the front rim. And that's Audrey Peck with her first board of the night, the team's leading rebounder by a significant margin. Peck averaging nearly 9 boards per game. Black fires away a three, back heel, Albert surging for the board but can't come up with it, but her hustle creates an extra possession for the Trojans. Now the officials will stop play as looked as if Gula was going to check in, but Kreps didn't make it to the scorer's table in time. So we'll play on here after the confusion. Peck from mid-range with a hand in her face. Got it off, but cannot hit. Santiago corrals the board. She hoists it down court in rhythm. Short range shot by Martin, no good. Audrey Peck scrambles for another rebound. Albert running the post, or the point rather. It's going to be interesting to see how the Trojans work out their point guard position. It'll likely be by committee as they continue to work in the absence of Denaria Washington. Here's a foul against the Trojans on the loose ball as Black was a little too strong on the layup there. Trinity looking to find some offensive rhythm. They have not hit a shot from the field so far this evening. Nothing out of five. The Redhawks off to a hot start, shooting 56% from the floor. And both of those numbers are going to have to change. Here's a wide open look for Santiago. No good. She gets a hand to it, though, and creates the extra chance for Martin. Good hustle by Santiago. Now careless inbound by the Trojans. And Martin has another, and Coach P.A. is not happy with that. A mental miscue by the Trojans as Gula on the inbound chucked it right into the chest of Martin, who was quick to pounce on it and score 4 points in a matter of seconds. So a tough start for the Trojans, who trail by a 14-1 margin here. Now Amber Reynolds is on the trainer's table, getting checked out for in her foot and ankle area, it appears. The Trojans can ill afford to lose another one of their key players, already down to just 7 uniformed personnel due to a litany of injuries and other mishaps. And we can only hope that Reynolds is going to be okay. Doesn't seem to be in a lot of pain, but always a concern to see her meeting with the athletic training staff. Well, we got to talk about Coach P.A. today. Coach P.A. is always styling out here, and today repping the Bad Boy Records Biggie Smalls jersey with the matching shoes. Coach P.A. always with a terrific personality and sense of style, and you can just feel her personality whenever you share a space with her. And always great to see just the vibrance on display. She always is breathing positivity into this team, even in the tough times. And the Trojans needing it here in the early going tonight. Not the start they were looking for. 14-1 in favor of the visitors. Albert appears to be the primary point guard option. She shuffles it over to Jasmine Smith. Smith driving baseline, flips it up too strong. Rebound snared by Emma Schmidt as the sophomore Schmidt getting her first action. Schmidt over to Best. Best working on Gula. Gets free and bangs home the step back triple. Impressive handles from Michaela Best. And a long-range three. Now Albert right back the other way. And boy, if that shot doesn't encapsulate what these Trojans are all about. They've been faced with adversity all year. A beautiful three gets splashed home, but they come right back at him. Now this effort from Bess is not on the money. And Gula has got the board. Braylee Gula works it past the timeline. Over to Albert. Here's Audrey Peck, who is really going to have to continue to carry a big load for the Trojans in the absence of some of their stars tonight. Smith had the pass stymied. Now probes inside. Good hands by Martin to prevent the open look for Hattie Black. But it'll stay with Trinity. Abby Tomblin checking in. The freshman guard. Now on the floor for the Red Hawks as they continue to rotate personnel. Best will get a rest here. Albert to toss it in. Looking for somebody, now flips it up for Gula, who was fortunate to be able to pounce on the Martin mishandle. Gula lost her dribble. Looking for an option. Trojans have to come to the ball here, and the shot clock expires A disjointed possession from the Trojans as they just looked out of sync for the entirety of that. And Coach PA, no matter what personnel is out there, she's not going to be happy with that. She's not making it easy on this team. Always expecting the most. Just pushing these players to be their best as there's a three-pointer from Sarah Martin. Trojans already trailing by 17, in need of an offensive spark. Albert stonewalled by Tomlin, now works her way free. Inside, Gula kicks it out for Smith. Smith working against Halfacre, Hattie Black to Peck, 7 on the shot clock. Peck, a triple, good! Audrey Peck seldom swings it from out there. But when called upon, she provides a big bucket for the Trojans. And some much-needed offensive momentum. Here's Tomlin to the inside. Straight up and down was Albert, denying it. Tomlin scrambles for the board. Out to Halfacre. Halfacre around the screen. Another three, no good this time. Audrey Peck has got it once again. Now Albert inside into a thicket of defenders, and it's poked free. Now ahead of the pack are the Red Hawks. Pop pass from Halfacre to Martin results in the easy deuce. Just over 2 minutes remaining in the opening period. Albert will take it out as the offense resets. Gula jostling for position. Out to Albert. Three-point attempt is off the front rim, but there's Jasmine Smith collapsing for the board and the finish. And the Trojan bench getting excited for their freshman with a key bucket there. Now the loose ball pinging out to Gula. Trojans looking to capitalize with a couple straight buckets here. Peck waiting for them to run through the offensive set, and now it is intercepted on the way to Gula. In front of the pack is Tomlin. Peck nearly had the denial, but it'll be called for the contact down low. And Abby Tomlin will head to the line to shoot a pair. Well, a nice spell of resistance here from the Trojans when they needed it desperately. As this one was getting off the rails here early, but the three-pointer by Peck pumped new energy into this team, and then the great hustle from the true freshman guard, Jasmine Smith, as she snags the loose ball and puts it up for the easy two. Tomlin hits the second one as Audrey Peck will check out. And the first action of the night for Kayla Kiskowski, another Trojan freshman. We'll have a great opportunity to take advantage of here tonight. Hattie Black trying to make her way to the interior, but it's Halfacre coming away with it. She's got a head start and will lay it up and in. Trinity a bit careless with the ball here early, and it's leading to some transition opportunities for the visitors. And you cannot afford to surrender easy buckets to a team as skilled as this Red Hawk squad. Albert gliding inside but couldn't finish. Gula, a tenacious board, and the bucket. Braylee Gula providing a physical presence on the inside and gives a lifeline to the Trojans. Now Tomlin, a wild shot off glass, wrestled down by Hattie Black. Trojans looking to go quickly. Black had it poked free but maintains possession. Gula crashing toward the inside. Lost her dribble. Great feed, though, to Albert, who draws the foul. Boy, there just is not an ounce of quit in this Trinity team. They get punched in the face to set matters in action tonight. And now they have rekindled that offensive spark. A great feed by Braylee Gula. Looking like a point guard as she fired that pass on a line to Albert, who is the beneficiary, shooting a pair right now. Two out of two for Kaya Albert. She trims the advantage to 13. Final possession in all likelihood here of the first quarter for the Redhawks. Good hands by Albert to poke it free out of the hands of Tomlin. But the ball remains with Indiana University. Halfacre. In the waning seconds, a deep three, front rim. Albert could chuck it up good if it goes, but well short. And the Trojans closing the first quarter with some momentum. After a difficult start, dug them into a deep hole. They surge out of it and play their way back into this thing. They still trail by 13. But they have got some life and energy that was desperately needed. An absolutely nightmarish start for the Trojans, especially playing against such a talented squad. But they do not back down, they do not give up, and that was on full display here as they were trading buckets throughout the remainder of the first quarter after that dreadful start. Kaya Albert leading the way for Trinity, one of the Trojan captains. She has really been called upon more and more for TIU as the season has plodded onward. And she's got herself 5 points and three rebounds while really filling in as a primary ball handler, which is not a role that it seemed like she would be likely to occupy throughout the majority of this season, but the Trojans so short-handed right now, and Albert has stepped up nicely tonight. Audrey Peck drained a pivotal three, and it was great to see Jasmine Smith pouncing on the loose change and getting herself a bucket. Just the more confidence that that young freshman can build up, the better off the Trojans will be. And she is really starting to work herself into the flow of collegiate basketball more and more as she gets the chance to be out there. A couple of storylines that will be interesting to keep an eye on is the presence of Carly Miller for the Redhawks and Amber Reynolds for the Trojans, both of whom appeared to suffer injuries to the foot and ankle area. The Redhawks obviously have a lot more depth. They have got Miller back on the bench, but it doesn't appear that she will re-enter the game soon. Now, another hard collision here as this one's knocked out by Tiara Jackson, but a hard fall there for Madison Weary, the senior guard. But see, she pounces up and seems to be okay. Reynolds, on the other hand, we are not seeing right now on the Trojan bench. Just Audrey Peck on the bench in uniform, so hopefully she's all right. Gula will pitch up a three, and that one rolls out of bounds after clanging off the front rim. So the Trojans could be down to six active players here tonight, and they are really going to have to show their tenacity to stay in this one. Here's a feed to the inside, and Jackson stepped on the boundary. We've seen a couple of times when Jackson has wriggled free under the cylinder, has great instincts down low, and her teammates know when to get it to her. But good defense there, the Trojans not having it. Albert over to Gula. Gula on the perimeter. Power dribble toward the inside. Looks for an option, has one in Kieskowski. To the inside and Black, but it's picked off. Good hands on the play by Sarah Martin. Emma Schmidt over to Martin, no good. Rebound grabbed again by Albert, who is a menace on the boards tonight. Undersized, but just finding a way to get it done. great instincts for the loose ball. Smith, feeling some confidence, pulls up the midi. No good. Gula fighting for the board to the inside, and a powerful move by Braylee Gula. Braylee Gula showing some tremendous fight for the Trojans and a great physical presence for the blue and white. Now here's Emma Schmidt working against Black out to half acre. She'll fire from at least a half acre away, but this time she'll drive to the inside. Now there is Jackson, pitches up an air ball, rebound Smith. Smith nearly lost her dribble on the pursuit from half acre, but now she's got a head of steam into the paint, puts it up, no good, looking for her own, and it'll stay with the Trojans. An explosive effort from the freshman Jasmine Smith, trying to go the full length of the floor and get herself a bucket. And you know, blink and you would miss it, but the Trojans are only 11 points down in this thing. They are working their way right back into this contest. Ball poked free, but Smith is able to retrieve it. To the corner, Black in rhythm off the front rim. Peck came soaring in for the board, but did not get it. Now the pass up ahead of the field, and Martin gets the lay. Good long-range feed by Emma Schmidt. Kieskowski over to Audrey Peck. Peck hoists it to the inside, but it's knocked free by Martin. Now Michaela Best back in the contest. Goes the length of the floor and gets that one. So just when the Trojans were starting to close in and make this a game again, Best and Martin will enlarge the advantage with a pair of transition lays. Peck got mired there. Now flips it over. Kieskowski to Albert. Albert, mid-range J, no good. Rebound Schmidt. IU looking to get out and run again. Half acre over to Schmidt. Schmidt with a little hesitation, driving to the rack, and a nice finish at a sharp angle from Emma Schmidt. Here's Peck to the inside, and Albert gets hacked among a crowd right there. So Kaya Albert has been extremely decisive in this contest so far, as Jasmine Smith will head to the bench after another energetic spurt. But Albert knows that this is her time to shine here, with several of her high-powered counterparts missing action. And she has played an extremely decisive contest. Second one is money as well. A pair of free throws are good for Albert, who continues to lead the way. Now she's got 7 for TIU. Here's Martin hanging in the air and takes the bump. She will head to the line. It's been a nice evening from Sarah Martin. She's already in double digits, has 11 points on 5 of 7, has been getting to the rim unobstructed and finishing, using her speed to her advantage, as the first free throw is no good. She's continuing a terrific campaign, as she is the active leader in points per game for the Redhawks. Got 12 and a half, slightly ahead of her teammate, who has also been impressive tonight, Tiara Jackson down low. She's got a total of 12.2 on the year. The Redhawks without their top scorer on the season, Michaela Schmidt, and they are still firing on all cylinders offensively tonight. This is in and out from Hattie Black, and it will go to the Redhawks. IUNW doubling up the Trojans early, but it looked like it could be a lot worse than that, as Trinity fell behind significantly, 14-1 down. Here's a three-pointer by Schmidt, and she drains it. But nonetheless, Trinity has really showed some fight and some fire and stayed in this thing. But the going has been tough, especially digging out of a hole like that. Black comes up short. Now here comes Schmidt looking to capitalize in transition. Good effort by Kieskowski, but she draws the foul on the swat, and it'll be an and one opportunity for Emma Schmidt, who's providing a spark off the bench. She has nailed both of her shots from the field on successive plays in total, 3-for-3. As this one's no good, rebound tipped out, but into the waiting arms of Black. Now Smith couldn't stay under control as she fired it off the backboard. Here's Martin feeling herself and splashes home the middy. Sarah Martin is on fire tonight. She's got 14. Another timeout for Trinity here as the Red Hawks have got some momentum back. Leading by a significant margin here. Coach PA wanting to give her players a rest as well as continue to instruct them. She's got to space out her timeouts, a real challenge playing with just six players at the moment, as she's practically got to get every single one of them through 30, 35, or even 40 minutes of basketball. And Coach PA and this Trojan team doing all they can, showing off a ton of dedication and perseverance right here tonight, as their numbers are just continuing to dwindle. Smith will inbound it. She's got Gula. Gula looking for the pass. There comes the double. Now it sags off. Gula lost her dribble. Bounces it inside to Black, who works through the contact, but it's no good. Martin on the defensive effort. Now Martin over to Schmidt, quickly in rhythm to Samantha Martin. But she got hacked under the tin, and it'll be an inbound for the Red Hawks. Under 5 minutes remaining in the opening half. Quick hitter, it's Martin to Martin. Sarah to Samantha for the bucket there. The Trojans looking to stem the tide. They'll turn to their veteran, Kaya Albert. She's got 7 to lead the way for Trinity. Nearly had it pickpocketed by Schmidt. Now she'll flip it over to Black to avoid the sideline. And Black draws the contact. Gliding toward the baseline, she gets up the shot and will head to the line, trying to score her first bucket of the afternoon. Been a tough start for Hattie Black, 0 out of 6 from the field, but she's still made some contributions. Has got 4 rebounds for the Trojans, tied for the team lead along with Albert, who has been impressive in her own right. Couple of players that aren't the tallest, aren't the most physical down low, but just have a knack for that basketball, as second one is on the money from Black. She gets in the score sheet. Here's Martin looking to build on a 14-point effort. Instead, she gets it to Schmidt looking for another three. She misses from the field for the first time. Samantha Martin cleans it up and hits the fall away and one. Well, the Red Hawks really enjoying their depth here, as players outside of the starting five are making key contributions tonight, especially as we saw Carly Miller, a key player and a starter for them, knocked out of the game in the opening minutes. She's returned to the bench but has not returned to the floor, dealing with an ankle injury. Here's the pass to Gula on the inside. Schmidt has got it. Schmidt overshoots Santiago. And Albert's there to clean it up. Albert threading her way inside. Boy, that was a nice scoop shot through the contact, but the foul appears to be on the floor, negating a brilliant effort from Kaya Albert, who is in rhythm tonight. Gula takes a spill as Black skies to haul it in and gets the finish. Hattie Black with her first field goal. She's 1 for 7 on the evening. Now Best over to Santiago. She flings it back to Best. Best with the quarterback-like feed. Now Best on the cut and one for Michaela Best. The Red Hawks continue to manage the minutes of their starters, but they are not taking the foot off the gas pedal. We have seen great games from Michaela Best and Sarah Martin. Complimentary effort from the bench squad as well. IUNW firing on all cylinders. We'll see what the Trojans can do for a counter. Through the hands of Gula, she's got time to regroup. Hattie Black, 15 on the shot clock now as she hands it off to Albert. Albert working against Santiago. Shot clock running down. Double comes. Here's Gula working in the post. Gula too strong. A nice move from Braylee Gula, but all for naught, and there is Emma Schmidt on the cut. A solid evening from Schmidt. She's got 9 off the bench. Albert working her way free as she high steps to the cup but can't get the finish. Now Santiago still looking to get her first bucket of the evening. Best to the outside. Martin has been on fire. There's Samantha Martin, no good. Hit nothing but the backboard there. And Hattie Black has got it for Trinity. Just over 2 minutes remaining in the opening half. Black kicks it out for Kieskowski. Now Black flips it inside, an errant feed, but Kieskowski is able to haul it in. She gets it out. Black steps into a tray. No good. Rebound off the bounce for Samantha Martin. Now Best, a step ahead of the pack. And Indiana University Northwest is a bucket away from the halfway point to the century mark here. They put up 49 with 100 seconds still to go. Gula sets the screen for Albert. Albert to Kieskowski. She tries to work free. There's Smith, a three-pointer, just a little too strong from Jasmine. Here is Best. This Red Hawk team just showcasing terrific speed. Love to get going in transition, and that'll likely be a point of emphasis for the tired Trojans to find some way to cope with the wheels of this Red Hawk squad. That effort from Schmidt is a little bit too strong as we close in on a minute to play. Kieskowski holds it high above her head and shuffles it over to Gula. Braylee Gula to the inside. Bull rushing toward the cylinder. Now she passes it out for Black. Black from the corner off the rim. Martin looking to go quickly to Best. Fall away from Best. And she has got terrific body control on these jump shots. We saw her with the step back three and now the fall away from the inside. These are powerful, decisive moves from Michaela Best, who's got 9. Albert to the inside. Triple team comes, but it frees up Braylee Gula. Nice feed and great awareness from Kaya Albert and Gula the benefactor. 8 seconds left. Santiago puts her head down. Black nearly with the steal. There's Martin, another bucket for Sarah Martin. She has been a dynamo in this first half. 16 points on 7-9. But that is going to conclude matters for an entertaining opening 20 minutes. The Trojans down early. Fell into a gaping hole out of the gates, and they have been playing catch up ever since. But good perseverance by this team. Amber Reynolds was knocked out with an injury in this one. A bad ankle keeping her sidelined, and hopefully we get positive news on her in the long term. But these Trojans giving it everything they've got and just putting up a terrific fight despite the fact that they trail by more than 30 here. We'll see if they can right the ship and continue to scrap in the second half. And we will be back for that momentarily. Your halftime score is IU Northwest 53 and the TIU Trojans 21. We'll be right back. Well, howdy, folks, and welcome back to Van Dixhorn Arena, where the Trojans are currently trailing against Indiana University Northwest in the women's game, 53-21. The most telling stat, perhaps, in that first half. The Red Hawks of IUNW have 22 bench points, and the Trojans are down to one remaining bench player. So that perhaps accounts for the sizable deficit here. Trinity is giving it everything they have got and fighting against forces on and off the court tonight. If you're just joining us, they fell into a cavernous hole early on, trailing 14-1. They never quite retired from that, but they did have a strong spell shortly thereafter before seeing the deficit enlarge where it sits now at 53-21. But great effort from the Trojans. You saw after that first half, the Trojans' star center, Bradley Gula, just lying on the ground for several minutes, just recovering a little bit. And you know, you wonder, why are the Trojans playing themselves to exhaustion with six people in a game that in all likelihood for this season will not have a lot of impact, as they will in all likelihood not be postseason bound this year? Well, it's about creating a culture, and this is where that is built. And we're seeing right now this Trojan team laying the groundwork, laying the foundation for what will hopefully be several strong years to come under Trinity's first-year head coach, Courtney Pia. And this team has a great intensity about them. They have a great positivity about them, where even when things are not going their way, even when they're struggling, they're still going to give you their best shot and live with the results. Those results haven't always been kind to them, that they are just getting started in terms of what they're going to be capable of accomplishing. Don't forget the nightcap tonight. After this one finishes up from Van Dixhorn, we will have the Trojan men's team. You see them getting some shots up right now. And they are going to have an exciting battle after this, as they will take on the Indiana University Red Hawk men's team. Greg Miller's Trojan men having a nice season this year. They're 13-10 on the season. And they are just such a fun collection of characters to watch. You've got the terrific scorer and passer, Keontae Thomas. The combustible bucket getter, Diamond Presniakovas. Got the sniper, Jack Cahoon. The extremely athletic big, that is Brandon Lawani. Right on cue, he throws up a between the legs, off the backboard dunk while getting loose. And, of course, the do-it-all man, Xavier Cooper. And it is going to be a lot of fun to watch those that I just mentioned and others. Such an exciting and entertaining team. They play at a breakneck pace from start to finish. And buckle up if you're going to watch them play. It is going to be a lot of fun in the second contest tonight. First things first, we got 20 more minutes for the Trojan women, and they are in the trenches right now. They are ready for war. A team that has showcased so much perseverance this year in a situation where lesser squads, lesser players, lesser coaches would have wilted. They continue to give it everything that they have, and then some. They are laying the groundwork for something special. And I think everybody in the building, everybody who's associated with that program, this program, believes that. Now, it might take some time. We saw the same thing with Coach Luke Ward when he took over the women's volleyball team. They had a season record, which is potentially the record that the Trojans will have after this game, barring a miraculous comeback. 3-21 is how they finished their first season under Coach Ward. And this past season, less than significantly less than a decade later, they become NCCAA national champions. So there's plenty of hope. You get the right people in the building. You get players that are not just talented, but high-character people. And you get a hard-nosed, energetic leader who will walk with you to hell and back. And you've got a recipe for something special. It just might take a little bit of time to cook up. Well, 10 more minutes on the clock. And the Trojans are ready for battle. It is Albert, Black, Smith, Peck, and Braley Gula out there for the home squad. The visitors send out Santiago, Martin, Halfacre, Best, and Tiara Jackson. There's the whistle, and away we go in the second stanza of this one. Albert continuing to run the point. Kicks it over to Black. Black around the Gula screen. Now Gula will try a three. It's money! It is money! A rare three-pointer from Braley Gula. She comes out firing with confidence. And that'll breathe some life into these Trojans. They are fired up after the aerial strike from Gula. Now Best looking for the answer. Flips it up. No good. As Black has got it. Athletic midair adjustment from Santiago to prevent the pass to Albert. Now here's Martin for three. And my goodness, she has had an absolutely scintillating start to this contest. 16 points already for Sarah Martin. Albert looking to go all the way. Correction, that is 19 after the three. Martin shooting the lights out, 8 for 10. Here's Halfacre, a sniper in her own right. Now Martin thought about a heat check, but instead directing traffic inside to Best, who pulls up. No good. Over Peck. But Hattie Black has got her back and cleans it up. Black slowing it down. Trinity will get in their half-court set. Albert double-teamed. The sideline's the third defender, but she squirts free. Peck to the corner. Black was open, but the pass offline, and she's unable to corral it cleanly. Missed opportunity for the Trojans there. Michaela Best, we didn't see all that much of her as she will take the ball up here starting the second half. She started the game, but has played limited minutes. She's been impressive, though. 11 points and three dimes for her. Martin to the inside. Jackson muscling through the contact. And we'll head to the stripe. Well, just about everything I was saying about Best goes for Jackson as well. We didn't see too much of her out there, but she's been really impressive. A couple of nice layups that she has just been so under control, getting to the basket, being decisive. And the Redhawks have definitely got a good one in the post with Tiara Jackson. She also leads the team in rebounding with an impressive 12.3 boards per game. Here's Black pushing past Santiago. Now Jasmine Smith. Good ball movement as Gula pops it into Kaya Albert for the finish. Great work by the Trojans. The extra pass from Gula. And a solid move to finish that one off. Now here's Jackson under the cup. Second effort as good as she got her own. 58-26. The Redhawks have the lead over the Trojans, who have come out of the second half with some purpose, however. Gula trapped in the corner. Slings it to Smith, who works it to Pack. Good hands by Martin, but she stepped on the boundary. Shot clock reset as the possession changed. So a good break for the Trojans. We'll have a full 30 to work with. Seen Martin be active on both ends, but she's unable to create the turnover there. Hattie Black comes all the way to Albert to get the inbound. But this was tipped up. And Best to the inside for Martin. Another point. And Sarah Martin has got 20. Or 21, rather, to lead the way for the Redhawks. Peck on the inside. Been a quiet afternoon for her offensively. Just the 1 3-pointer and just 2 attempts from the field for Audrey Peck. They may need her to shoulder a bigger load here late. Black with the three. No good. Almost pinged back out to her. But instead it's Halfacre. She flings it up for Martin. And Martin again finding her way into the lead. And just getting into a track meet. Now Black wasn't expecting the pass. Halfacre has got all kinds of real estate as she flips it up and through. It's a party for the Redhawks right now. The Trojans looking to erect a dam and stop this constant flow of energy and productivity. Here's Peck with the fall away. Tries to get her own, but she'll be called for the foul, reaching over the back of Sarah Martin. Unbelievable numbers from Sarah Martin tonight. She's got 23 points on 10 of 12 shooting. Extremely efficient, and credit to her teammates for getting her the ball in stride as she has managed to get ahead of all 5 white shirts in transition, taking advantage of the fatigue that the Trojans with just 6 active players are dealing with. Here's Emma Schmidt. Schmidt has 9 off the bench. To the inside. Jackson. Double team comes, but a foul against Peck, who got her hands in the cookie jar there. Didn't seem to be a lot of contact as Peck was definitely making a play on the ball. And that is the 5th foul against Audrey Peck. And Coach PA saying, you've got to be smarter. Jackson on the inside gets it over to Martin. And my goodness, it's like we're watching this one on repeat. Sarah Martin, another bucket. She's up to 25 for the ballgame. Trojans cannot afford to lose Peck, who has been fighting foul trouble all afternoon. Should she be disqualified from the contest, they will be down to 5 players who would have to play every single minute of this one. Kieskowski over to Smith. Smith to the inside. Black with a great catch, but she had nowhere to go with it. Tomblin's got it. Tomblin, give and go with Santiago. Now good position by Tiara Jackson as she gets the finish. Doing a nice job getting her body planted down low, and the feed was on time and on target. So the Redhawks continuing to pour it on an offensive onslaught. And they have got 66 with just under 5 minutes to play in period number 3. This is where it gets really, really tough for the Trojans. A team that really had some depth early in the year. I mean, some of the players you're seeing out there, Kaya Albert is tied for the lead scorer for the Trojans, and she was a bench player in the early going. She's got 9 points. The other joint lead scorer for Trinity, Braylee Gula, started a decent amount of games, but she would be rotated in and out alongside Saskia Stegbauer and Jakaya Amos, both of whom are not active for the Trojans tonight. So Gula is being forced to shoulder a massive load, and she's done a really nice job with it, as has Albert. Those two combining for 18 points. The Trojans are going to need some offensive production outside of those two, however, as especially with Audrey Peck getting in serious foul trouble. So I believe she has been disqualified with her 5th foul. Just a correction on that, assuming that that number is correct. The Trojans are down to 5 players for the final 15 minutes of this ball game. These are valuable minutes, though. I mean, you look at these players, and you did not think that we would see these five for such an expanded stretch. But you've got Albert getting a chance to really take over as the alpha, as the number one. Got valuable opportunity for Hattie Black, who continues to take on a bigger and bigger role. Gula has a great opportunity to really take over in the post. She'll put up another three here. That one is offline. As Gula has got a big smile on her face there. She knows that's not her game, but maybe a bit of a heat check as she splashed one earlier. And then you've got the pair of freshmen with Kieskowski and Smith, who were borderline garbage time, out of the rotation players, as here's the pull-up by Schmidt. It is money. But those two getting a great chance here to really assert themselves and show what they can do and maybe play their way into a rotation spot, even when the Trojans are whole and healthy, hopefully toward the end of this campaign or in future seasons. Black flips it out for Kieskowski. Tomlin closed the distance and nearly had a steal, but it'll stay with Trinity, 13 on the shot clock as we're under 4 minutes to go. Third quarter action from Van Dixhorn. The shorthanded Trojans giving off Leonidas and the 300 vibes as they continue to scratch and claw. Gula might have to fire up another three. Instead, she tries to feed it through to Albert. Tomlin will get the finish. And I think Sarah Martin could have scored that one easily, but she said, hey, I've got enough points tonight. Let me give some love to the reserve freshman, Abby Tomlin, who has been a force defensively this evening, and she gets rewarded with the easy bucket. Well, the deficit just continues to swell tonight. It is 72 for the visiting Red Hawks and 26 to Trinity. But don't think that you're going to see any let up from the Trojans. Every minute valuable. And playing the game the right way has been an emphasis ever since Coach PA took over. And you will see a lot of things from this Trojan team. And effort is always going to be amongst them. Effort, positivity, hustle, team play. That's what this program is built on. Braylee Gula getting stretched out there as she might be cramping a little bit. But they've got no choice but to leave her out there. A Herculean effort from Gula and the other four out there tonight, who are playing practically the entire contest. Amber Reynolds was sidelined from this one with an ankle injury. She has joined the Trojan bench, but she is not in uniform. And Audrey Peck picking up five fouls at a very inopportune time leaves the Trojans with just five active players. An interesting contingent out there, but they're giving it everything they've got as Gula will get to the line, and now she is clutching at her knee and calf area as she'll try to stretch out a little bit. Boy, that would have been a terrific finish from Gula on the sharp angled push shot. Good sportsmanship from the Red Hawks as they stay around and help up the Trojan warrior that is Braylee Gula. Gula, such an energetic personality on and off the floor as she continues to give it her all for this Trinity team and bringing positive energy and smiles at a time when they are desperately needed. Trinity trying to wear this one and continue to make progress in the right direction. So hard when you don't have all of your personnel. Just a fraction of the players Trinity thought they could count on are out there right now. Second one also no good. Jackson clears the rebound. To the corner, it's Martin. Thought about a three. Instead, she flicks it inside, but through the hands of Jackson, who says, my bad, that pass had some steam on it. And couldn't quite be snagged. by Tiara Jackson, who will head to the bench in favor of Samantha Martin. Several substitutes in for the Red Hawks as they look to the stretch run. No doubt they will be a big factor in the postseason picture as Albert misses the layup. Trying to keep fresh legs out there at all times, keep their squad healthy. Samantha Martin puts it up, rolls off the rack. Kieskowski got a hand to it, and Gula continuing to scrap for the board. Trojan ball. Less than 3 minutes left in this one. Schmidt will head to the bench in favor of Michaela Best. Rayleigh Gula high-fiving her teammates there. I thought she was going to the bench, but there is no Trojan bench. They are down to five active players right now, so a long swath of opportunity ahead for all these players. There's Hattie Black, a nice finish on the inside. Hattie Black has not had her most efficient evening, just her second field goal on 12 attempts. But she continues to persevere and gets that one to sift through. Three-pointer from Tomlin looking to answer, no good. Martin soars for the rebound, pulls up from the mid-range, and my goodness, it is automatic for Sarah Martin. She's got 27 points, and we're not even done with the third. Albert to the inside. Black was free for a second but didn't realize it. Now she falls on it. And finally, the whistles blow, a jump ball. Bodies hitting the floor. Even given the chasm of a deficit that the Trojans are facing, Rayleigh Gula slow to get up. She is continuing to deal with cramping, but showing the true heart of a lion as she plays through the issue here. And will have to do so for the remaining 12 minutes of play. Tomlin to the inside. That was off the foot of Samantha Martin. Somehow wasn't called. And a soccer assist for Samantha Martin as it came right back to Tomlin on a fortunate bounce. Everything going right for the Red Hawks here. Timeout is called as Gula will try to stretch out that bothersome calf. There is still a long ways to go in this thing, and perhaps just a stoppage for injury. I don't believe that was a full-on timeout, but the officials giving her a moment to try and get right. And boy, I mean, it's easy to say, you know, watching over here, like, you can do this. But to be playing for this long without a break, this sport will get you going back and forth down the floor as there's Albert with a nice bucket. She has shown no signs of slowing down, but it is so tough for these Trojans what they're going through from a conditioning standpoint. Tremendous perseverance and all credit to all five of these Trojans finding a way to fight out here as there's a nice layup off, high off the glass from Abby Tomlin. She's starting to pour in a few buckets, has five now. Albert couldn't create separation. Now she'll sling it on to Kieskowski. Kieskowski harassed by Wiry. To the inside, Gula got position to the cup. Rayleigh Gula limps her way out of it, but another bucket. To her terrific night, give Braley 11. Scoop shot from Best, she's got it. Now the three hoisted up by Tomlin, no good. Kieskowski has got the board. Gula calling for it. There goes Albert though. What a finish by Albert as the period expires. Albert beating the buzzer with an improbable, sensational, astonishing finish as she hoisted that from her left hip with two hands and kissed it off glass for the stanza concluding two-pointer the Trojans somehow continuing to show energy at a time when, by all accounts, they should have none left. They simply will not give up. Trinity still reeling from a 78-34 deficit, but you have got to give them a ton of credit for the way they are battling down the stretch, the heart that they are showing. And you see a tale of two teams here, two teams that play a very similar brand of basketball, that have got great coaches and great coaching staffs, and you can really see what the Red Hawks are doing here, being the Trojans in a couple of years. This is a Red Hawk team that's very deep, ton of talent, but great team play. You saw it with Sarah Martin having an all-time ball game here. She's got 27 points, but still has got a wide-open look. Instead, she shuffles it over to Tomlin, giving her teammate some love, and Abby Tomlin gets the easy bucket. That's the type of selflessness that great programs are built on. You see that from the Red Hawks, but you see that from the Trojans as well, as they are laying the building blocks to climb to the heights that a team like the conference-leading Red Hawks have achieved. It's a process. There might be a significant cooking time on the recipe, but once this is all baked up, I think the Trojans are going to be a force to be reckoned with. They've got some of their pieces. Their pair of star sophomores in Denaria Washington and Saskia Stegbauer, both of them on the bench today, out injured, cheering their team on. And you think with those two, that Trojan window can be extended, of course, but they would love to be able to have a top-notch team within the 2 years that those cornerstone players will be here. Black pulls up. That thing bounces over the cylinder, somehow hopped over both rim sides. Wiry. Now it's Halfacre. Thought about a tray as they circumnavigate the perimeter. Now inside out to Tomlin, who measures this one, and it's off the rim. Kieskowski has got another board. Now Smith crashing toward the baseline. Albert looking to penetrate. Smith has the loose changes, triple teamed as she tries to wrestle it free. It's a jump ball on the possession arrow, indicating the Red Hawks' direction. 9 minutes remaining in the contest. The starters continuing to see some minutes, but rotating in and out as the Red Hawks look to get their players the right action. And there's a nice bucket from Michaela Best. She's been impressive tonight. Give her a 13. But now it's just about for the Red Hawks getting ready for the rest of the season. Gula pulls up another tray. That thing almost went down. Whereas TIU just trying to continue to grow the culture, show what they're made of. Bucket there for Madison Wiry. She's got her first points of the evening. Gula missed the cutting black. Now she'll burrow her way inside, and a great finish from Braylee Gula. She is playing her heart out and still scoring at a high level here. Samantha Martin coming back with a push shot bucket. 84-36. This one is definitely out of reach, but the positive signs continuing to tumble in for the Trojans. Black looking for a strong finish. Thought she had contact, but no foul. Wiry toward Tomlin. Gets it out to Wiry. She steps into a tray. It is off the mark. Hattie Black trying to go all the way. Has it tipped free, but she'll recover it. Smith thought about the triple. Coach PA urging her to shoot that one. Trying to build confidence in her young freshman, as this one's knocked out by Tomlin, who has had a ton of tips on the defensive end tonight. But this one will stay with the Trojans. Some confusion perhaps as the Red Hawks never gained possession, but the shot clock was reset. Shot clock back down to 11 as Smith with a veteran move from the freshman as she takes advantage of that time to get some fluids in her system before making the inbound pass. Here's Black out to Gula. Gula driving, spinning to the outside. Black flips it up off the front rim. Albert has got it, puts it up. No good again, and it's going to the Red Hawks. Kaya Albert has been impressive on the boards. Just 5'5" is Albert. But she has got herself a remarkable total of 5 boards tonight as the Red Hawks continue to pour it on. Albert working on Tomlin. And timeout called by Coach PA. Not sure if she didn't like the offensive set or she just wants to get her players a much-needed breather as they continue to pick their way to the finish of this one. This is what it feels like when you're out there for that pickup run and, you know, you realize you've got a good team and you win 5-6 games in a row and you keep on taking on different squads. By that 7th game, you're going to be absolutely exhausted, and you know, that's part of the pickup basketball system. You know, you get tired eventually and you drop a game or two, but there is no relief for the Trojans as that clock continues to amble its way down to zeros. And there's still a long ways to go, nearly 6.5 minutes remaining. And great perseverance from Trinity as they lost Audrey Peck to a 5th foul early on in the second half. Nice scoop shot by Hattie Black. She's got herself 7, nearing a double-double, and she's also got 10 rebounds. 3-point answer is no good from Wiry. But you've got Peck out with the fouls, you've got Reynolds out with the injury, and now you've got 5 Trojan players trying to navigate their way to the end of this thing. It is a mission and a half for the 5 remaining Trojans. But they are continuing to mount a spirited effort. There's Albert with the mid-range. Long rebound out to Gula, who crashes her way inside. But it's no good. Halfacre palms it down to Tomlin, who has another bucket. That's 9 now for Tomlin. 8 different Red Hawks have scored as they are getting balanced contributions led by Martin's 27, Best 13, and 13 for Halfacre. Now a foul called under the bucket. Just a remarkable offensive showcase from the visiting side. They're shooting 60% for the field. Some of these lines are tremendous. It'll stay with Trinity here on the deflection. Martin with 27 points on just 14 shots. She is 12 out of 14. Emma Schmidt, an efficient 5-for-7 for 11 points. Albert getting clever there as she threw it off the back of Sarah Martin and nearly had a bucket. Gula spilling to the ground to try to grab that one. Oh, man. Trojans continuing to empty the tank. But yeah, terrific offensive showcase from the Red Hawks. And a terrific showcase of perseverance for the Trojans. There's a rare miss from Martin. Black tried to haul it in, but she spilled over the boundary. I'll scratch that. It was a Red Hawk that touched it last. I guess Black was just looking for the foul call as there was some contact near the baseline. Albert pounding it into the floorboards. looking for an option, has black. The tired Trojans continuing to claw through their offensive sets. Gula just racing to the rim. And Braylee Gula just playing with abandon right now as this one will stay with Trinity. Gotta love the determination from 30 and White. To the inside, Black nearly had a free lane. Now she falls away off glass. A terrific shot from Hattie Black as she is starting to heat up offensively. The 17th shot for Black, and she's starting to find a rhythm. She's got nine now. Schmidt too strong. Wiry nearly has the board. Black diving for it. And boy, you don't see bodies lunging to the floor like this in a 49-point ball game very often. But that's just the effort that characterizes this Trojan team. Wiry off the inbound three-pointer is a little bit short, but there is Schmidt looking to clean it up, and it sifts through the cup. 91 for the Red Hawks as they close in on the century mark. Albert looking to add to her impressive evening tonight. She's went over 20 points one time this season against Maranatha Baptist, looking to do it again here as Black is taking over offensively, draws the contact as she is making things happen in the low post. A free throw here will give Black a double-double. She has been a monster on the boards, 11 rebounds, looking for her 10th point, and she has got it. A double-double for Hattie Black. Impressive stuff from her. And she is just a go-getter out here for the Trojans. Now you hear the reaction from the Trinity bench as they realize what's went down. Halfacre looking to go quickly. Gula grabs the uncontested board, flat-footed. Albert, boy, she has just been going at full throttle all evening long. Albert with terrific cardio on display tonight as she works her way around the pick from Gula. Out to Black. They feed the hot hand. Black to the baseline, lost it. Got poked free, and it'll stay with TIU. So Hattie Black creating a positive storyline for sure for the Trojans. 11 points and 11 boards for her. Albert trying to feed her on the inbound, but it's turned over to the cup. It is Tomlin and one on the late contact from Kieskowski. Count the bucket. And Tomlin is in double figures. She's got 11. One of five Red Hawks to have passed up the 10-point threshold. Emma Schmidt with 13 off the bench. Tomlin, 11 off the bench. Caitlin Halfacre with 13 off the bench. Keep in mind that the Trojans don't have a bench right now. Two teams in vastly different positions that are both impressing in their own way tonight. Albert pulls up. No good. Didn't catch anything there. As Albert was looking to splash home a momentum-changing triple. Good closeout by Sarah Martin. And timeout for TIU. Now this Trojan team showing a lot of positivity, continuing to encourage each other as the athletic training staff continuing to stretch out Gula. They've almost made it to the finish line. Just 3 minutes left in this one. TIU putting up a tremendous resistance here. The heart of a lion from every single player on this TIU team. Amber Reynolds, by the way, in the Trojan huddle right now, but she is on crutches and has got the shoe and sock off of that right foot. So that is not the news that anyone wanted to hear, especially the Trojan contingent, as the Trinity key players continue to drop. Reynolds was such a key presence, a great leader, one of the captains this year, along with Albert, and brought a key dynamic in terms of scoring to this Trojan team. She was among the lead scorers for much of the year. Provided big time contributions and spacing the floor, drilling long range shots, and no word on exactly what's going on with her, but we have to hope it'll be a short term absence. There is Martin, puts up the long range effort, no good, and Martin has missed each of her last two shots after starting 12 out of 14. Smith has a full head of steam but couldn't hang on to possession. This Trojan team right now, maybe not going through perfect sets on the offensive end, but they're saying, I'm going to go right at you, kick you in the teeth, and we're not going to back down for anything. As there goes Emma Schmidt with the tray. She's got a quiet 16 off the bench. IUNW just 3 points short of hitting 100. Albert to Gula. She's going to cue up another tray. Rims out. Black on the case. Puts it up. Smith, another effort. She's fouled. And a pair of offensive rebounds for the TIU Trojans. They trail by 45, but they play every minute like it's 0-0. And Jasmine Smith will go to the line to shoot two free throws. She has got 2 points tonight. And she nails the first one. The Trojans fired up as Smith adds to her point total. Key buckets and key confidence for the young freshman, Jasmine Smith. Looking to get her fourth, and she does. Two out of two from the charity stripe. Martin on the baseline. They work it around the perimeter. Halfacre wanted another three-point attempt. Now Martin looking to get her 30-piece. Instead kicks out to Tomlin. The bank not friendly there. And Kieskowski has got the rebound. Albert taking her time with it. Over to Smith, good hands from Halfacre, but Kieskowski on the case had it poked free at the last possible moment. Now Martin looking to go all the way, another bucket as she breaks her mini slump of two consecutive misses. With the lay in there, she's got 29 as a chance to reach that elusive 30-point threshold. Albert to Hattie Black. It's been the Hattie Black show of late as she draws the contact again. A masterful evening from Hattie Black. She has just got no fear. Fired up 18 shots for the Trojans. Made it to the line an additional three times. She is just brings a gritty and determined nature to the Trojans each and every night. And I think this team feeds off her energy. She's just a fearless player, a fearless scorer for TIU, and she's been outstanding on both ends of the floor. She hits the second free throw. 12 points and 12 boards for Hattie. Halfacre. Gula got a hand to it. Halfacre back in there. Albert doing jumping jacks, denying the pass. Now Martin looking to crack the 30-point threshold. Scoops it up. No good. She tries to get her own. Does one more try, and she's hacked by Braylee Gula. So Sarah Martin continuing to add to a terrific outing. 29 points on 13 out of 17. 6 rebounds and 7 dimes for the senior guard from Crown Point, Indiana. And she nails the free throw. It's a 30-piece from Sarah Martin. And you've got to give her teammates a lot of credit for making that happen. Some great feeds to set her up all evening long. Whenever she broke to the basket, the ball would be there. And especially with the star Michaela Best only playing so many minutes tonight, it was point guard by committee, great feeds all over the place. Now Albert off the heel. Albert stumbling for the board. Smith laying out. Three bodies hit the floor. And Wiry will pull it out. And the Red Hawks will try to run out the clock, but Smith is still chasing her. Boy, the Trojans just playing to the final whistle. Smiles on the faces of both players, Smith and Wiry, as they've got a ton of respect for each other. Smith jawing now, continuing to hop up and down. Great persistence from the freshman there. And that encapsulates this evening for the Trojans. As shorthanded as they were, it was so difficult for them to try to stay in it with this high-powered Red Hawk squad. But these teams have got a mutual respect for each other right now because they fought until the end in this thing. The Trojans will get a little bit of much-needed rest for a couple of days before they face the Red Hawks Indiana University counterpart, the Titans of Indiana University South Bend. Landmark evening for the Red Hawks as they get their 20th win of the campaign. Sarah Martin leading the way with 31 points. Michaela Best had 13. Caitlin Halfacre, 13. Abby Tomlin with 12. And Emma Schmidt with 16. Great and diverse offensive effort. But what about those Trojans? You had Kaya Albert posting a 13-point effort. Hattie Black, a double-double, 12 points and 12 rebounds. And Braylee Gula with 13 points, including splashing home a triple as she battled through those cramps to continue to deliver excellence. And that's what Coach PA preaches all evening long and all season long. Excellence, effort, and positivity. And there is just a galvanizing nature to this team right now. They are a unit, and they gave it everything they had. And Coach PA has got a lot to be proud of as she shares an embrace with Braylee Gula, who played her heart out tonight. What an evening for these Trojans. Unbelievable perseverance, and they truly have earned the moniker of Trojan Warriors tonight. Well, don't forget, folks, the Trojan men will be in action shortly. Tip-off for that ball game at 7:30, so be sure to join us momentarily. This is Ethan Oskroba signing off, but not for long. The Trojan women putting up a tremendous battle as they fall to the Red Hawks. Be sure to join us momentarily as the Trojan men go to work.
step out onto the court and use the talents and abilities that you've given us for your glory. We ask you to watch over us this evening as our athletes compete and keep them safe from all harm. In your name we pray. Now fans, let's meet tonight's starting lineups. First of it is in the Red Hawks. At guard, a 5'10 senior from Chicago, Illinois, number 2, Malik Miller. At center, a 6'8 senior from Hopkins Park, Illinois, number 11, Lamarius Willard. At guard, a 6'2 junior from Lake Station, Indiana, number 20, Ryan Lafayette. At forward, a 6'5 senior from Chicago Heights, Illinois, number 23, Jared Johnson. And at forward, a 6'5 junior from Chicago, number 25, Isaac Stendak. The Red Hawks are led by assistant coaches Devin Ellis, Steve Patchett, Eric Roland, and Alec Constantaris, with head coach Javier Pereira. And now, the starting lineup for your TIU Trojans! At guard, a 6-foot sophomore from Bowling Green, Illinois, number 2, Keontae Thomas! At guard, a 6'3 junior from Oswego, Illinois, number 22, Jack Calhoun! At forward, a 6'3 senior from Wayne.
All right, folks. Well, as promised, we are back in action. The TIU Trojan men going up against the Indiana University Red Hawks here at Van Dixhorn Arena. You know the story with this Trojan team. They like to play fast. They play with a ton of energy, and they have played well this season. They're 13-10, as here's the bank shot jumper by Lamarius Lillard, the 6'8 center, showing off some of his versatility there. But Trinity loves to get out and run in transition. They have several great athletes and like to use them to great effect. Here's Jack Calhoun, the sniper, with his first field goal attempt of the night. And that comes up short. Bowled out of the mess by Lillard. Now it's Ryan LaFollette probing, and the three-pointer by Isaac Stanback. It's no good. Board corralled by the Trojan star, Diamond Presniakovas. Brandon Lawani thought about a three. He jump stops to the inside and gets Trinity on the board. The Red Hawks having a solid season as well. They're 11-13. On the year, looking to inch a game back toward 500 as the Trojans look to continue to separate themselves from the 500 mark. LaFollette is pursued by Thomas. A double team comes, but he'll flip it back out to Jared Johnson. Johnson, long range bomb, no good. Great rebound by Lillard, but it's poked free. Xavier Cooper comes away with it, flips it all the way down court. But a little bit out of sync with Calhoun. Here is Malik Miller. He will run the point for the Red Hawks. Miscommunication with Johnson there. But good ball movement gets Lillard free for the little push shot. And he puts it home. Xavier Cooper will take the ball down the floor for Trinity. He and Keontae Thomas are a couple of the primary ball handlers. There's Thomas feeling some confidence. Throws up a three. It's no good. Presniakovas almost had the steal, but instead it's Miller exploding to the cup. And a hot start for IU and W. The Trojans looking to bounce back after a 20-point loss against Roosevelt. Last time out, there's Lawani getting the bucket. Trinity looking to rekindle some momentum after their offense was stymied in that contest, held to just 53 points. Uncharacteristic for this high firepower Trojan team. Active hands to force the turnover now as Cahoon comes away with it, turns on the afterburners, but Miller stonewalls him. A foul is called against Miller, so a good break for the Trojans, who will hang on to it. Trinity is in their home grays, the Red Hawks, wearing black with those red accents. It is Keontae Thomas, Jack Cahoon, Diamond Presniakovas, Brandon Lawani, and Xavier Cooper, the five out there for Greg Miller. And Javier Heredia, the head coach of IUNW. As there goes Presniakovas on a nice cut and a good feed. The Trojans' leading scorer gets his first bucket tonight. But for the Red Hawks, it's Malik Miller, Lamarius Lillard, Ryan LaFollette, Jared Johnson, and Isaac Stanback. Here's Miller, shoves it inside, and Johnson suspends in the air and gets the finish. Cooper turns on the Jets. He's swatted from behind by Stanback. That thing bounced off the backboard and actually created momentum for LaFollette, but the Trojans return the favor. Great pursuit defensively by TIU. They got bodies back and were able to repel the counterattack from LaFollette. Lillard listed as a center, and he's got great height, but he can play all around as he goes up here and draws the contact. A lot of height out there, period, for this Red Hawk team. As you've got three players, 6'5 or above. Lillard listed at 6'8, though. Looking at him alongside his teammates, that might be a bit of an aggressive figure, but still very tall, as is Jared Johnson and Isaac Stanback. Both of those two standing at 6'5. So great height and great length that make this Red Hawk team a force to be reckoned with. And you've got LaFollette at 6'2 and Malik Miller at 5'10 as the second attempt from Lillard is no good. Lawani works it back out to Thomas, was looking to get the elbow jumper, but he couldn't get the release. Now the windshield wiper. A Jordan-esque finish from Brandon Lawani. Got his man going the wrong way to shuffle free. Hit the shimmy and the finish. Now out of sync are the Red Hawks. LaFollette hit the cut at exactly the wrong moment. A look of exasperation on the face of Jared Johnson as he picks up the turnover. The Trojans, after a slow start, have trimmed the four-point deficit to just one, looking to take their first lead of the evening. Presniakovas lofts it up for Lawani. Lawani is all knees and elbows, but he delivers a pinpoint feed. Keontae Thomas finishing through the contact. The flexible release from Thomas as he was suspended in the elements. And found a way to force that one up and through. Terrific finish from Thomas, who spent much of the season as the Trojans' lead scorer. He converts the three-point play. But Thomas leads this team in assists, second on the team in scoring, leads them in steals as well. A force on both ends for Trinity. There's a great cut from Jarrah Johnson. And the big man connection as Stanback feeds him up. You got big guys that can dole out dimes like that. It's tough to stop. Now here's Miller off the turnover as he trots his way through and has something to say to Thomas, and he gets teed up. Thomas has got a smile on his face there as Miller, showing a bit of a lack of discipline, had to rub it in to Keontae Thomas, and he'll cost his team perhaps a couple of points if the talented sophomore Thomas can put these free throws home. The Red Hawks staff not happy with that, as first free throw is no good, but Miller might have shuffled with it. It looked like he took a few too many steps as he trotted his way toward the bucket. A great finish nonetheless, but he had to have a little something to say, and that'll cost his team a singular tally there as Keontae Thomas drills the second free throw. Thomas, a 68% shooter from the line. So it's an aspect of his game you'd like to see him continue to work on. This Trojan team as a whole wants to get better at free throw shooting. He's got one out of two there. Now here is Presniakovas off the pirouette. It's no good. Stanback comfortably taking it up the floor despite his burly 6'5 frame. Now here is Keanu Lane putting it up, and crashing to the rack was Johnson. Looked like he finished through some contact. No call, but no call necessary. Impressive finish for him. Now Thomas, mid-range, no good. And Jack Cahoon took a spill, and he is down and writhing in pain, and he's clutching at his forehead, and that is not what you want to see. Such a key player for the Trojans, and he seems to be in some pain here. Got tangled up in the post while contesting for the board. And he is still face down as he converses with the training staff. Boy, Jack Cahoon's such a key player for this Trojan team as he's able to get to his feet, but noticeably disoriented. That is unfortunate. Hopefully, he'll be cleared to return soon. But Cahoon, a noted sniper from the outside, a decisive cutter. He's got great scoring instincts and has really become a fixture in the Trojans' starting lineup, and he will head to the sideline. Boy, it's been a really unfortunate night with injuries out here. Otherwise, really enjoyable basketball has been marred by several players going down. Here's Tyler Houston. He turns on the burners, becomes up short. Monte Lambert has the board, flips it out quickly for Thomas, and it's off on Thomas. It is as an unlucky break. It hit his head as it was swatted out of bounds. But we saw in the women's game, saw Amber Reynolds suffer an injury. She was on crutches after that. We saw Carly Miller of the Red Hawks suffer an ankle injury as well. She was able to walk it off somewhat, but she did not return to the proceedings. Now Jack Cahoon taking a hard blow to the head. So not what you want to see out here. It's a part of the sport as Stanback hits the mid-range J to put the Red Hawks up by five, but it is something that absolutely nobody likes, no matter who you root for. Lawani flicks it out for Lambert. Lambert, the New York native. Terrific scorer, terrific athlete. Always brings life on the offensive end. Now Lawani gets tangled up, and it's a jump ball. Nice work from the Red Hawks there, forcing the issue, as if you give Lawani time and space to operate in the post, he'll make you pay every time. Here's Cooper off the inbound feed, no good. Strong rebound, clapped down by Johnson. Johnson hits the little stop and go and flips it out to no one in particular. Thomas almost had a brilliant dribble move, but couldn't hang on as he got caught between a dribble and a pass down the court to Xavier Cooper, who was breaking free. So the rival squads trade turnovers. And now a push off against Tyler Houston. Keontae Thomas clapping it up. There was a little bit of an extension of the arm by Houston, but I definitely think Thomas sold that one a little bit. A cagey play from the second year man. Lawani will head to the bench for a break, as Asher Bloom will check in for the first time. Really talented backup center for the Trojans, plays second fiddle to Lawani, but he brings a lot of ability to this offense and defense. Presnikovas went up, but he lost it. Houston flips it out. Good ball movement. Three-pointer for Lillard. And he puts it home. LaMarius Lillard making it rain from the outside, and an ambush from the Red Hawks. They lead by eight. Now Lambert picks his way inside, throws it up off the cylinder, no good. Red Hawks could have a two-on-one. Here's the lob, and it's finished off by Lillard, perfectly in sync with the Johnson feed. And this has been impressive stuff from the Red Hawks as the Trojans call timeout. Already a 10-point lead for the visitor. Boy, you look at their record. Nothing really jumped out about this team, but I really like their approach. They're playing almost positionless basketball. They've got bigs that are athletic enough to run the point, and they've got guards that are sizable enough to play in the post, and they just like to come at you quickly. Whoever's got the ball, get in the best position for him to do something with it. They're not too worried about what personnel is deployed or where. They are simply going to come at you. It's almost a street ball type of vibe, and this is the future of basketball, going away from defined positions to optimize the game. It's almost the basketball counterpart of the total football concept that you think about in soccer, pioneered by some of the greats like Alfredo Di Stefano and Johan Cruyff with their respective squads. And you gain such an advantage when you've got the personnel where you can put a variety of people in a variety of different spots. And that's the way that the Red Hawks are coming at the Trojans so far today. Here's Presnikovas. Leads the team in scoring this year. They can use a couple buckets right now. Thomas flips it out to the do-it-all guard Cooper. Cooper to the inside, and Bloom couldn't slingshot it down as he waved at it. The Red Hawks smelling blood in the early going here. 12 minutes remaining in the opening half. Pass inside and now out, but it was sprayed away errantly by Keone Lane. Keontae Thomas, the Trojans' leading assist man, has had an outstanding sophomore season. Gives it up for Bloom, trying to bank bodies in the post. Little give and go. Bloom is soaring to the rack, and he gets hacked. So Bloom with a decisive drive, just making it happen, and creates the opportunity. Well, the Trojans' foul is on the floor. And now here is Colby Cross into the ballgame. He missed significant time with an injury. He is a key man for the Trojans. A great long-range shooter as we see number 10 get some action. Thomas flips it over to Bloom, in and out of his hands. Davion Washington thought about stepping into a triple. Instead, he works it back out to the perimeter. Lambert nearly picked it off. Instead, it's Lane money. And the lead is up to a high watermark of 13. This is the same score we saw in the women's game, 25-12 in favor of the visitors. A suboptimal start. Now Cooper hoists it up. It's no good. Bloom looking for reinforcements. Has it knocked away. Here goes Lane to the outside. Stop and go, and triple is snapped through by Jared Johnson. What a start for the visiting side. 28-12. The Trojans have been punched in the mouth to start things off here on a Wednesday night in Van Dixhorn. My goodness. Well, you talk about how good it is for the Trojans to have Colby Cross back, as he missed significant time with an injury, did not play at all in the month of December or January. As they continue to work his minutes up, he's a significant presence off the bench for TIU, the team leader in free throw percentage, shooting 83%, and he is also second in three-point percentage on the team, shooting 44% from beyond the arc. Lawani is stifled here, and oh boy, Lane almost flew up for the jam, but his hubris, perhaps his weakness on that occasion, didn't quite have the ups for the standstill dunk. Lawani does, however, as that one settles through. So a big-time bucket at a big time for the Trojans. Houston running the point as the Red Hawk staff was disgusted with the foul, the technical against Miller, and perhaps teaching him a lesson here. Three-pointer in and out. Washington soars for the rebound to the inside. Rim run by Lillard, and he puts it home. Plus the contact. Boy, everything is clicking for the Red Hawks right now. Lillard looking to complete a three-point play and keep all that momentum on the Red Hawks side. They are more than doubling up the Trojans' tally. What do Greg Miller's boys have for an answer? Here's Cooper to Lawani, and now Thomas going to work with it. Out to Cross. Lawani finds the open man Lambert. He leads the team in long-range shooting. Lambert fires it in to Lawani, back for Thomas. Thomas stonewalled by Houston. Tough shot, but he gets it to go. Boy, a terrific fall away look by Keontae Thomas. Shades of the great Kobe Bryant on a look like that. Now three-pointer for Washington. Boy, everything's been going down for the Red Hawks, but not this one. Nice cut by Lambert. Acrobatic finish, but it won't go down. A quality feed by Thomas. And Lambert tried to make that mid-air adjustment, but couldn't quite get the reverse layup to go. Lane with the three over the backboard. So Trinity, a team that's short a couple men. Nothing like what we saw with the Trojan women's team, but Jaden Thomas and Stratton Lovorn, a couple of terrific young players for the Trojans, out with injuries tonight. Here's Cross with the three, no good. And Miller back in the game, lobs this one up for the gliding Johnson, who puts it home. Well, one way or another, the personnel the Trojans have out there, certainly strong, and you would hope that they would get right in a matter of moments here. No good on the three from Lawani. Rebound wrestled loose by Standback. Standback hits the stop and go. Pops out to Johnson. Now Standback on the wing. Jackhammering his way inside. Looking for something. Falling away. And he gets the shooter's bounce. Timeout is called. And this is getting a little bit ugly in a game that felt very winnable for the Trojans. They have dug themselves a significant deficit, trailing by a 35-16 margin. a concerning start for this Trojan team. Well, the Trinity offense has been fairly stagnant, but the bigger problem has been the defensive effort so far, as they are surrendering a 63% rate from the floor to IUNW. A lot of that you've just got a hand to the Red Hawks. They've been terrific here early. But the Trojans, this team has struggled a little bit defensively all season long. It's been their Achilles heel. They've got an offense that could have them right at the top of the conference, and they're just trying to continue to shore things up on the defensive end. Tonight has been a setback in that regard. But credit the Red Hawks. They have taken it right to the Trojans, shooting 63% from the floor. Also, a quick housekeeping note. Jack Cahoon is in the huddle with his Trojan teammates after sustaining that shot earlier in the period, where his head hit the ground pretty hard. He's got some ice on the forehead right now. It doesn't seem like he'll be returning, especially given the tricky nature of head injuries. But it's good to see that he's functioning fairly normally and seems like he's going to be all right. Hopefully a short absence for him. Teardrop is good for Presniakovas off the Luani feed. Now Johnson for Malik Miller. Malik Miller, great body control as he floated toward the rack and put that one through. Thomas into Cross. Back to Thomas, looking for Cross, but he was cutting. Great instincts by Cooper to hang on to it. He says, I'll take that. Puts up the shot, but too strong. Board snared by Lillard. Miller around the screen, and now Thomas is down, grabbing at his shoulder, and finally the officials blow the whistle. He was rolling in agony for a couple of seconds there before they stopped it, and Thomas seems to be in a lot of pain, and my goodness, this unfortunate run just continues. The fourth player we have seen fighting some sort of an injury tonight, and the third Trojan in these two games, the women's and the men's. And we saw Thomas perhaps slightly injure his shoulder a couple of games ago, and you wonder if this is a continuation of that, as he's definitely got that characteristic angled walk and is clutching at that left shoulder, I believe it is. Oh boy, just tough scenes here at Van Dixhorn. He's in some pain. Good to see him able to get up and try and stretch it out a little bit as he talks with the Trojan training staff that has been busy tonight. Just the dark side of athletics in general. And Thomas, who's in the midst of a terrific campaign for the Trojans, sidelined here. He'll head back to the bench for the moment. Three-pointer in and out as Luani snags the board. Here goes Cooper to the inside, and a foul against Luani on the entry pass. Or rather, a foul committed on Luani, as Miller will check back out. He's picked up his third foul already. Obviously that technical not helping his cause. Luani misses the first free throw as Tyler Houston will check back in for Miller, who we may not see again for this first half, sitting on the trio of personals. Luani makes good on the second free throw. Well, checking in for the Trojans, it is Braden Betzner, the freshman guard, getting some big minutes here as Cooper forces the turnover. But Betzner, number three for the Trojans, will need to step up in the absence of Thomas. This one plinkoing about, but it gets ahead of the pack, and great teamwork as Lillard finishes on the handoff by Javion Reed. Now, Cooper changing speeds, works it out to Betzner, who slips it over to Luani. Luani got straightened up. Betzner for three, no good. foul under the cup will go against the home side. So the Trojans trying to stave off a Red Hawk strike. It is 39-19 in favor of the visitors, a 20-point gap separating these two. Here's Lillard on the baseline. Good ball movement as they continue to ping it around. Running down the shot clock are the Red Hawks. To the outside, three-pointer Johnson, money. And it's just automatic for the Red Hawks right now. It's their fourth three-pointer of the contest. Presniakovas looking to go get a bucket. Great tip in by Lawani. That's a big part of his game. We've seen it all season long. He will crash to the rim, use his athleticism and those veteran instincts to get to the cup. Now a deep three from Johnson, no good. Here's Cross, he'll take his time with it. As with Thomas out, it'll be point guard by committee for this team, and we'll scratch that. Thomas back in the game now, surprisingly. I hadn't picked up on that detail, but he'll fire away a three, and he says hello. No, I see you out there, Keontae Thomas, a three-pointer from the man who was injured moments ago. So that is great news for TIU that he's not only back in but contributing in a big way. Houston out for Johnson. Johnson picking his way through the rubble. Now stand back. Long range on the midi. He's got it. That is a long two for Standback. And now this pass projected ahead of the field. An errant throw by Keontae Thomas. So the 20-point Trojan deficit holding firm here. But boy, it is great to see Keontae Thomas back out there. This Trinity program cannot afford to lose another soldier tonight. We saw the Trojan women's game. We saw them lose Amber Reynolds, lose Audrey Peck to foul trouble. As here's the mid-range shot, no good from Standback. Rebound for Betzner. And then we see Jack Cahoon suffering the head injury. And it's just good to see that it's nothing serious in the case of a key cog in the Trojan wheel, Keontae Thomas. Last touch by Presniakovas in the baseline skirmish. So IUNW will go to work. It is Tyler Houston who's got an extended minutes at the point guard spot, and he rolls in his first bucket of the day. Using his length to create that opportunity and finish the gliding layup. Now Thomas, baseline fine, and that is Jack Cahoon. Oh boy. The Trojan unit is whole again. And I'm surprised to see that. Jack Cahoon back in the ballgame here. Given the tricky nature of head injuries, evidently he's been cleared to return. Lamarius Lillard was looking to catch a body there. But he's prevented by virtue of a foul. Well, in a matter of moments, we get both Keontae Thomas and Jack Cahoon returning to the contest, and that is a phenomenal sign for this Trojan team. A couple of key contributors there. Back in action for the blue and white. First free throw, no good from Lillard. As Lawani will head to the bench, we'll see the first action of the night for Nabil Kone, the Mali native. In his second year as a Trojan, he'll grab the rebound immediately. Off the second free throw miss. 0 for 2 from the line is Lillard. And here come the Trojans to the inside. Good feed. And the body contact will send Thomas to the stripe. So Thomas playing with no fear, leading with that left shoulder and going right into the contact. Seems like that might just be an issue that flares up on him from time to time. But it's his non-shooting arm, and he's certainly committed to playing through it. Some toughness out here from the second year man from Bolingbrook, Illinois, Keontae Thomas. As he puts the second free throw home, 68% from the line. And he is 3 out of 4 tonight. Toward the inside, boy, that one bounced off the head of Thomas, and a fortunate carom that it came back to Standback, who takes advantage with the nifty lay-in. Now Presniakovas, quiet night for him. He's got just 4. Kone going to work on the inside, lost the handle. Good defensive work by Standback. More substitutes for the Redhawks as Houston will head to the bench. And we'll see some work for perhaps the third string point guard, Trey Steinhilber, taking advantage of the foul trouble that both Houston and Miller are in. There's 2 fouls against Houston and 3 against Miller, so both those key players need to be around at the end for the Redhawks, or at least one of them, so smart move by the coaching staff as they bring in reinforcements. The turnaround effort is short from Standback. Now Presniakovas to Kone, who blasts off for the easy lay-in. Nabil Kone getting on the board. Just the 5th Trojan to score. And what has not been a terrific effort from the Trojans offensively. Here's a nice bit of work by Thomas, turns on the Jets. Oh, what a terrific bucket, but they're gonna say an offensive foul. Oh man, I'm not so sure about that one. It did not look like the defender was established, and he might have been the restricted area anyway. But they're gonna call it an offensive foul, negating an outstanding bucket from Thomas. But to conclude my earlier point, the Trojans haven't been bad offensively, but they're going to need to turn it up if the Redhawks are going to manage to maintain this type of performance on the offensive end. This is a Trojan team that prides themselves on their scoring. They're going to need a little bit more of it. They're clamping down defensively, however. There's Kone with the athletic block as he was coming down, managed not to foul. Now a great feed, Thomas to Cahoon, and a couple of players that we thought might be missing some time, and they're back out on the floor and contributing in a big way, cutting into this deficit. Under a minute remaining, half number one. Johnson running down the clock, perhaps trying to manipulate the timepiece and make sure his team gets the last shot on offense. That's a nice feed, though, as Javion Reed will crack the scoring column. Well, if that was the plan for the Redhawks, it's backfired here as the Trojans will have the last offensive look. Keontae Thomas will work against Reed, several feet from the bucket, putting on some moves. Triple is up and off the front rim by Presniakovas. Last second effort perhaps as Steinhilber tried to get a shot free. He does not. The Trojans clamping down defensively at the end, and they started to get their offensive motor going, but nonetheless they trail 50-31. Really strong offensive period for the visitors. They came into this building and applied the pressure right from the get-go, same as the Trojan women did, or rather the Red Hawk women did against the Trojans in the earlier contest. And we'll be back very shortly with more action here from Van Dixhorn. The Trojans trail by 19 after a half. Well, hello, folks, and welcome back inside Van Dixhorn as we get you set for the second half of what has been an exciting salvo between the TIU Trojans and the Indiana University Red Hawks. This ball game has got major implications in the thick of the CCAC standings. These two teams right next to each other in those standings. Indiana University Northwest 10-6 in the conference, and that's good enough for sixth place. The Trojans at 8-7 there in seventh. So these are big games as you're playing for postseason positioning and obviously the right to play in the CCAC postseason. So a major contest here. And so far it's been the Red Hawks that have gotten the better of Trinity, a team that aforementioned 10-6 in conference. They struggled with their overall record. They're 11-13, but don't let that fool you. They've played some outstanding non-conference competition that has led to that 1-7 non-conference mark, and they are coming out firing today. They're proving it. They're shooting 61% from the floor en route to a 50-point barrage that has the Trojans playing from behind. Trinity navigated through a minefield of difficulties, including losing both Jack Cahoon briefly to a potential head injury evaluation and losing their star guard Keontae Thomas to an apparent left shoulder injury. Both men have been cleared to return, and that's great news for the Trojan faithful. But they've got a long ways to go. They're going to need both those guys and really everybody on the roster if they're going to find a way to vaporize this 19-point downturn and emerge victorious in this pivotal CCAC matchup tonight. A nice moment at halftime moments ago as the Trojan women's volleyball team, which in December capped off a 30-9 campaign by winning the NCCAA national title. They got their banner mounted next to the Trojan scoreboard. The whole team was there along with head coach Luke Ward, assistant coach Kennedy Mang, and especially with so many great veteran players in their final year on that team. Stars like Brianna Torres, Anna Skripshak, Lana Vujošević, all on the backside of their careers. Jalen Freeman, fifth-year player, the great libero for the Trojans, Emma Gallegos. I mean, so many great players, and that's just to name a few that are on their way out as Trojan players. And you could not picture a better send-off than winning the national title. And athletics up and down all the time. You see a team like the Trojan men's volleyball or women's basketball teams that are building that foundation. It's so cool to see what the end of the road looks like, what that final destination looks like. And this Trojan women's volleyball team really made believers in all of us this past fall. It was one heck of a season for them. Now back to business. The Red Hawks with possession here as there's a bump on the perimeter. Going to be called against Cooper. Some 40 feet from the bucket. Not a great foul against Cooper, but there also didn't appear to be a whole lot of contact. Inbound lobbed into Malik Miller, who's playing with three personal fouls. Now Ryan LaFollette had his pocket picked. We saw a little bit of Ryan early on as he started the game, but not much since. Now Thomas free to fire, gets the bounce off the rim twice. And my goodness, that was shades of the series clinching bucket a couple years ago by Kawhi Leonard in game 7 against the Sixers, except the opposite result. It would not go down. Now Thomas nearly had a steal, but he had stepped on the boundary. And possession sticks with the Red Hawks of IUNW. Miller looking for options. Scans and gets it out to Johnson. Lamarius Lillard inside to Johnson, who mistimed his leap. to try to get the subsequent board. 2-on-1, Cahoon with the layup on the Cooper feed. The versatility of Xavier Cooper, he really can do it all. Among the team leaders in a variety of categories, he leads in rebounding and is second in assists. A really unique combo for the extremely muscular and physical guard. Now battling for it under the bucket, and it'll go the way of Trinity. So TIU bringing some good momentum here into the second half as they look to reignite their offense. And there's Cooper just plunging toward the bucket. Takes the contact and gets the finish. Cooper 100% the aggressor there. And finding a way to give his team a timely bucket. Johnson pulls up from long range off the mark. He missed it left. Now here's Cooper, the hot hand, going in there again. It'll stay with Trinity. Boy, there's nothing scarier than when a player starts to feel himself a little bit and it just takes it right to the rack with authority. That's what we're seeing from Xavier Cooper. The Redhawks, I'm sure, thrilled to get the Trojans in the half-court set. Now here's Presniakovas. Shovels it over to Thomas for Lawani. He mishandled it, got it back. Three-pointer, no good. Cahoon almost had the tip, but Miller is on it. Miller to Johnson. Oh, my goodness. A terrific over-the-shoulder layup by Johnson. He's now got himself 16 points. An impressive effort from Johnson as he's now the lead scorer, a point ahead of Lamarius Lillard. Cooper free to fire, no good. Thomas times his jump properly. It's blocked, but back to Lawani. The fifth year man Lawani showcasing his veteran presence in the right place at the right time to collect the easy two. Stand back. Another one of these versatile guard slash forward type. Can do a little bit of everything. It's knocked loose. Here's Presniakovas over to Cahoon. Oh, yeah. Cooper has got it and puts it back up, but a foul, a loose ball foul, will put the ball in the hands of the Redhawks. A tough call there. That was almost a terrific finish from Cahoon, and Cooper seemed like he might have an and-one bucket. Instead, the Trojans give possession away. Cooper will take a rest here as he had been flying down court on a series of possessions, so a well-deserved breather for him, as we'll see Monte Lambert to the inside. Oh, baby! Standback went for the highlight, but he lost the handle. He was wide open. And trying to get a little too showy with it, and there's old reliable Brandon Lawani. And the deficit's cut down to 13. The Trojans are back in this thing. Malik Miller signaling for a timeout, jawing at his teammates. They're out of sync, and the Trojans taking advantage of it. TIU is right back in it. Well, the Trojan offense in the first half was so-so. They weren't overly impressive, and this is a Trojan team that prides themselves on their offense. But the condition was, if their offense is not going to be up to snuff, they're going to have to step it up defensively, and that's exactly what they've done here in this second half, only surrendering 2 points to their rivals through the first 3.5 minutes. They have trimmed the deficit down to 13 points. And the hometown Trojans have to be feeling a lot better about themselves and their prospects of victory right now than they did just about 5 minutes ago at the start of the second half. The Trojan unit sprinting out there. Coach Miller deploying Lambert, Lawani, Presniakovas, Keontae Thomas, and Jack Cahoon. Cahoon got burned on the cut there, though. Great move by Johnson, and it was in sync. A tough look to battle off there. And well-coordinated offense from the Redhawks. Now here's Lawani, had it knocked free. Second effort is good. Brandon Lawani finding a way to put it home for the Trojans. Here's Johnson. Not a lot of 6'5 forwards that are going to run the point, but that's the luxury that this team has. Miller rejects the screen. High steps through the defense. Out to Johnson. Got his man in the air. Flails it up. No good. And Presniakovas was pursuing the rebound but couldn't hang on. Trojans battling back early second half. Miller looking for somebody. A down swipe by Cahoon. Nearly had the steal. Now the elbow J for Lillard. No good. Presniakovas with a head of steam. Got options on the wings. Instead he goes right into his man. Offensive foul. And Lillard was tiptoeing the restricted area, but he was not quite in it, and he managed to get set. Took the shoulder from Presniakovas, who barreled in hard. Trojans are going to need more from their lead scorer, Presniakovas. He's only taking 4 shots from the field and has just 4 points. It's been a quiet evening for Cooper with just 2 points, Presniakovas with 4, and Cahoon with 6. Trojans have got great contributions from Keontae Thomas and Brandon Lawani, but their second unit really not contributing a whole lot so far, and they have several great scorers on this team. They'll need to get them going, will the Trojans, if they want to win tonight. 3-point effort, no good, stand back. So that one was well off the mark from Isaac Standback. He's had a solid evening so far. He's got 8 points for the Red Hawks, one of their solid complementary players. Thomas over to Cahoon. Cahoon against La Follette. Has it knocked loose. A whirl from Miller. Got it into the hands of his teammate Lillard, but now it's stolen by the Trojans. Here comes Monte Lambert. Lambert with the cross. Inside, good feed by Thomas. And maybe that'll get the diamond going. Timeout by IUNW. The lead is down to 11. As Trinity continues to ratchet up the intensity. And they have got plenty of time to further close in on their conference rival. But this is exactly what you want to see in the second half from the Trojans. They've allowed just 4 points, and they have come on storming out offensively and are on the verge of reducing the Red Hawk advantage to single digits. Both these teams have had a couple of players having a terrific night. Jared Johnson with 18. He's been all over the place for the Red Hawks. And Lamarius Lillard has 15 of his own for the IUNW squad. The Trojans have 10 from Keontae Thomas and 17 from Brandon Lawani. It feels like whoever is going to get their supporting cast going is going to have a great chance to win tonight. 3-pointer La Follette, and that is money right on cue. Ryan La Follette gets his first basket of the evening. A 3-point banger from La Follette. Lawani looking to answer. Cups it out toward Lambert. Lambert fall away off one leg. Did his best Dirk impression, but couldn't get it to drop down. Miller hits the accelerator. Flings it over the shoulder to La Follette. It is Johnson firing again. No good this time. Unable to break the 20-point threshold with that one. Now Lawani on the block. Dimes up Presniakovas. But Johnson skies for the stuff. And he subsequently throws it away, turning a great play into a non-entity there. Davion Washington back in as Standback will get a rest for the Red Hawks. Extended run here for Monte Lambert as the Trojans look to keep their offense humming. Inbound coming up for TIU. Tyler Houston checking back in for Malik Miller, who's still playing with those three fouls. Houston has two of his own. Oh, good find, but Cahoon couldn't get the finish on the reverse lay, left it a tad short. Now Johnson. Redhawks riding through their top man. La Follette, errant pass. Good pursuit by Thomas. But one of the Trojans did get a fingertip to it. Johnson the inbound. Here's Houston. He did a nice job running the offense, though he's not made a huge offensive contribution. La Follette is stifled on the inside. Mid-range J is good, and it's the sweet stroke of Lamarius Lillard. Lillard with 17, Johnson with 18. Those two combining for more than half of their team's points. Now Lawani floating toward the cylinder. No good. Rebound Presniakovas. Kicks it to the corner. Thomas hit the ground running, but the feed was a little bit off. Wrestled free by Lawani, and no good. There's a lid on the bucket for the Trojans this possession as they persevere but cannot get the finish. Now Presniakovas contesting the pass and wriggling free with it. He is slapped. And it'll stay the way of TIU. Boy, that was a loud sound. I could hear that with the headphones on up here. But I guess it was all ball, at least, in the eyes of the officials. And Presniakovas not lodging a complaint. Diamonds got it. He slings it out for Lambert. Lambert lowers the shoulder and gets the contact. Good work from Monte Lambert as he will earn himself a trip to the stripe. Quiet evening for Lambert. He is 0-for-4 from the field so far, but a key player for the Trojans off the bench, shooting a mind-numbing 54% from three-point land this year. He has been a key man for the Trojans off the bench. He gets hot in a hurry. He plays with an attitude. He comes right at you. He is really fun to watch. As Lawani will check out in favor of Nabil Kone as we continue to see the three-headed post monster of the Trojans with Lawani backed up by Asher Bloom and Nabil Kone. Houston taking it up the floor. It's going nowhere. Flips it out to La Follette, who worked his way free off the screen. Rebound off the head of Tyler Houston, who tried to keep it on that side, but unsuccessful in that pursuit. Trojan basketball. They're looking to continue to whittle down the 14-point Red Hawk lead. Thomas leaves it for Cooper. Lambert to Thomas. Thomas going to the cylinder, and he gets the contact. Well, you have to love the determination and drive of Keontae Thomas. You got a player like him who shoots really well, distributes it well. You can fall into those aspects of your game, but he never does that. He loves to get downhill, invites the contact, and gets to the cup with a purpose. Earns him a lot of trips to the charity stripe, where he's shooting 68% on the year as he puts that one home. Thomas now 4 of 6 from the free throw line. Correction, make him 5 of 7, actually. To the paint, Lane, outside, three-pointer for Washington, and it's on the money. Every time the Trojans seem about to shave more off the deficit, the Red Hawks come back. Cooper too strong on the tray. Houston sucks in the board. Let's play. lane. Aerial pass for Lillard. No good. Lillard's a sharpshooter. He's 7 out of 11 on the evening, but no good there. Now Thomas floating, swatted by Lillard. It's batted ahead of the pack, and Washington has got all kinds of space. He thought about a jam as the entire IUNW sideline rose to their feet. But the veteran senior just lays it up and in. Now he slaps the floor. He wants all the smoke defensively. Cooper trying to give it to him. Had it poked free. Cooper lost his dribble. Gets the pass up and over, but Thomas has to retreat off the Houston tip. Just 6 on the shot clock. Lambert has to make something happen. He has it poked free. Great defensive stand for the Red Hawks. And a transition foul by Keontae Thomas. A frenzied sequence, but the Trojans could not find a way to get a quality look. The Red Hawks galvanizing on defense and finding a way to prevent the Trojans from generating anything promising on that possession. We've nearly reached the midpoint of the final period. Just over 10 minutes remaining in this contest. Red Hawks were put under some pressure, but they have managed to parry the Trojan attack as there's a three drained by Keone Lane. So once again, a 20-point advantage for the Red Hawks after Trinity had nearly cut it to single digits. Now Lambert blocked from behind. Almost got it back. Cahoon does. He flips it up. Off the rim, and Kone with the great pursuit to get his second bucket of the evening. Kone, a perfect 2 out of 2 from the field. Tyler Houston has gotten extended minutes with his point guard counterpart, Malik Miller, in foul trouble all evening long. Houston to the inside. Johnson tried the quick hitter, but it was well read by the Trinity defense. 11 on the shot clock as the Red Hawks will still have it. Wide open is Washington. Pump fake, now a tray, and he knew that was money from the moment it left his hand. Washington starting to combust here in the second half. He's got himself 8 points off the bench. Presniakovas, nice layup there, using his length and great body control. Shades of Dr. J as he reaches from the wrong side of the backboard and scoops that one through. Stand back, bull rushing to the cup. 3-pointer, no good. Washington had the heat check there. The Red Hawk bench was ready to explode if that went down. Now here's Lambert, takes the bump and finds a way to finish, and Lambert's saying, where's my call? That should be a 3-point play opportunity for Monte. Now he's starting to turn it on offensively, his first field goal, and he's got 4. Now Reed, good ball movement. Washington again, and he's got this one. 11 for Davion Washington, and a pair of threes in recent moments. Cooper gets hacked. So the 20-point advantage remains for the Red Hawks. This score here shows just how low-scoring the Trojans' defeat to Roosevelt was the last time out, as this was the final score, 73-53 in favor of the visitors. But there's still 8 minutes remaining in this one, and it's a good thing there are, as Presniakovas puts this one up, and they've credited him with the and one. Wasn't sure if they'd given it to him, but he does finish through the contact in a big bucket for Presniakovas. The free throw is good, and the burly senior Presniakovas is a great man to turn to when you're in need of a quick bucket, and I think that was a big one for the Trojans there. Open jumper for Lane as he worked his way free, but it's no good. 2-on-1 for Trinity, maybe a 3-on-1 if they hustle. Lambert takes it himself, but he's too strong from a sharp angle. Stand back's got the board. Thought about threading it through, but now they work it to the cup, and Javion Reed gets the finish through the contact. So the Trojans struggling to build consistent momentum whenever they strike back. The Red Hawks manage to turn it on in their own right and counter the Trojan strike. So we saw the three-point play for Presnikovas. Javion Reed has got a chance to notch one of his own.